Hello viewers, today we are going ahead and discussing about the structural feature elements of a building or a house. We know that the important structural elements have been the foundation, the footing, the types of wall. So let's go ahead and continue with the other structural elements important for a building in this present session. A third important structural element, which is lintel and sunshade. Openings for doors, windows, cupboards, etc. in the walls are essential. Therefore, the support to the load above the opening is given by providing a lintel. A lintel is a horizontal structural supporting member and a sort of beam, the width of which is equal to the width of the wall and the ends of which are built into the wall. Lintels are simple and easy to construct. These may be constructed with wood, stone, brick, either plain or reinforced, RCC and steel. At present, lintels of RCC are widely used to span the opening for doors, windows, etc. in a structure. Classification of lintels. Lintels can be classified based on the material used in the construction. Wooden lintels. Now, wooden lintels are the oldest type of lintels. These lintels are used only at places where wood is cheaply available. As wood is not resistant to fire and possesses poor resistance to atmospheric agents and insects, it is not recommended for important work. Wood used for lintels should be well seasoned and coated with coal tar to improve its service conditions. A single piece of timber can be used as a lintel, or built-up sections may be formed by bolting two or three timber pieces to serve as a lintel. Stone lintels. Stone lintels are used at places where good quality stones are available. Stone lintels can be found in plenty in old temples, forts, etc. Its use is usually confined to stone masonry structures or buildings faced with stone. Nowadays, use of stone lintels is really rare. The stone lintels consist of slabs of stones which are placed across their openings. Stone lintels may be formed of a single piece or more than one piece. Stone lintels are not generally favored due to many reasons. Brick lintels. As plain brick lintels have poor tensile strength, they are limited for spans up to 60 cm with light loading conditions. Plain brick lintels are constructed either with straight or wedge-shaped bricks. They are suitable for small openings with light loading conditions. Reinforced brick lintels. Reinforced brick lintels are stronger than plain brick lintels, as the courses of bricks laid as lintel are reinforced suitably. For this, longitudinal MS or ripped steel bars are provided in the joints between the adjacent bricks to impart tensile strength. This type of lintels may be used for spans up to 2.50 meters. Red cement mortar in a ratio of 1:3 should be used in the construction. The bricks used should be of good quality. The bricks are so arranged that 2 to 3 cm wide space is left lengthwise between adjacent bricks for the insertion of reinforcement mild steel bars. The gap or joint is filled with 1:3 cement mortar. Vertical shear strips of 6 mm diameter wire are provided in every third vertical joint. Main reinforcement provided at the bottom of the lintel consists of 8 to 10 mm diameter bars, which are cranked up at the ends. Steel lintels. Steel lintels consist of steel angles or rolled steel joints. Steel angles are used for small spans and light loading, and rolled steel joints are used for large spans and heavy loadings. Steel lintels become useful when there is no space available to accommodate the rise of an arch. Normally, steel lintels are provided where the opening is large and where the superimposed loads are also heavy. It consists of rolled steel joist or channel sections, either used singly or in combination of 2 or 3 units. When used singly, the steel joist is either embedded in concrete or cladded with stone facing, so as to increase its width to match with the width of a wall. When more than one unit is placed side by side, they are kept in a position by tube separators. Reinforced cement concrete lintels. Reinforced cement concrete is the most suitable and commonly used material for lintels. It is resistant to fire, insects, temperature stresses, and atmospheric agents. It possesses excellent resistance to tensile stresses with minimum size and is best suited for long spans and heavy loading conditions. They are economical and easy in construction. RCC lintels have replaced all other materials for lintels. No relieving arches are necessary when RCC lintels are adopted. The usual concrete mix for RCC lintel is 1:2:4. That is, 1 part of cement, 2 parts of sand, and 4 parts of aggregates by volume. The amount of reinforcement depends on the span of the lintel, width of the opening, and the total load to be supported by the lintel. RCC lintels may be precast. Precast RCC lintels are convenient for small spans up to 2 meters or so, and they are economical as the same mold can be used to prepare a number of lintels. Precast RCC lintels increase the speed of construction and allow sufficient time for curing before fixing. One precaution to be taken in the case of precast RCC lintels is that the top of the lintel should be properly marked with tar or paint. This will help in placing the lintel correctly. Let's go ahead and discuss about step and stair. Step. It is a combination of tread and riser and permits a person to ascend or descend from floor to floor. Types of steps. Steps in a stair may be of the following types. Flier. A flier is an ordinary step of uniform width and rectangular shapes in plan. Bullnose step. A bullnose step generally provided at the bottom of the flight projects in front of the newel post. Its end near the newel forms the quadrant of a circle. Round-ended step. A round-ended step is similar to a bullnose step, except that it has a semicircular end which projects out from the stringer. Splayed step. A splayed step is also provided at the beginning of the flight with its end near the newel post. Commode step. A commode step has curved tread and riser. Dancing step. Dancing step or balancing steps are the winders which do not radiate from a common center. Winder. Winder or tapering steps, such as those which radiate from a point usually situated at the center of a newel. A stair is a set of steps leading from one floor to the other. It may be defined as a series of steps suitably arranged for the purpose of connecting different floors of a building. It may also be defined as an arrangement of treads, risers, stringers, newel post, handrails, brusters designed and constructed to provide comfort and safe access to different floors. It provides access between the floors and facilitates movement of occupants from one floor to the other. The room or enclosure of the building in which the stair is located is known as staircase. The opening or space occupied by the stair is known as stairway. Types of stairs. Straight stairs. These are the stairs along which there is no change in the direction on any flight between two successive floors. Quarter turn the stairs. They are provided when the direction of flight is to be changed by 90 degrees. The change in direction can be effected by either introducing a quarter space landing or by providing winders at the junctions. Half turn stairs. These stairs change their direction through 180 degree. It can be either dog-legged or open newel type. In case of dog-legged stairs, the flights are in opposite direction and no space is provided between the flights in plan. On the other hand, in open newel stairs, there is a well or opening between the flights and it may be used to accommodate a lift. These stairs are used at places where sufficient space is available. Three-quarter turn stairs. These type of stairs change their direction through 270 degrees. In other words, direction is changed three times with its upper flight crossing, the bottom one. In this type of construction, an open well is formed. Circular stairs. These stairs, when viewed from above, appear to follow circle with a single center of curvature and large radius. These stairs are generally provided at the rear of the building to give access for servicing at various floors. All the steps radiate from a newel post in the form of winders. These stairs can be constructed in stone, cast iron or RCC. Spiral stairs. These stairs are similar to circular stairs, except that the radius of curvature is small and the stairs may be supported by a central post. The overall diameter of such stairs may range from 1 to 2.5 meters. combination of different type of stairs. Depending upon the requirement of a building or as per owner's demand, few of the types can be combined to design a new stair. Roof. Roof is a flat or sloped cover at the top of the building which is constructed in the form of framework to give protection to the building against rain, heat, snow, winds, etc. A roof basically consists of structural elements provided at the top of building for the support of roof covering. The structural elements may be trusses, portals, beams, slabs, shells or domes. The roof covering may be of AC sheets, GI sheets, tiles, slates or slabs. A well-planned roof must satisfy the following requirements. First, it should have adequate strength and stability to carry the superimposed dead and live loads. Second, it should effectively protect the building against rain, sun and wind. Third, it should be waterproof and should have efficient drainage arrangements. It should provide adequate thermal insulation. It should be fire resistant. It should provide adequate insulation against sound. Most form of roofs construction provide an adequate insulation against sound from external sources for majority of buildings. Types of roofs. The selection of the type of roof depends upon the shape or plan of the building, climatic conditions of the area, type of construction materials available. Flat roofs are considered suitable for buildings in plains or in hot regions where rainfall is moderate and where snowfall is not there. Flat roofs are equally applicable to buildings of any shape and size. Curved roofs have top surface covered. Such roofs are provided to give architectural effects. Curved roofs include cylindrical and parabolic shells and shell domes, doubly curved shells such as hyperbolic, paraboloids, hyperboloids of revolution, and folded slabs and prismatic shells. Curved roofs are most suitable for public buildings like libraries, theatres, recreation centres, etc. Now, roof may be divided into three categories: pitched or sloping roof, flat roof or terraced roof, and curved roof. Pitched roof. A sloping roof is known as a pitched roof. It is the most common form of roof and is generally regarded as the cheapest alternative for covering a structure. These are suitable in those areas where rainfall, snowfall is very heavy. Pitched roofs are almost constructed in steel or wood. They are basically of the following forms. Leaf to roof. This is the simplest type of sloping roof provided either for a room of small span or for the veranda. It has slope only one side. Gable roof. This is the common type of a sloping roof but slopes into two directions. The two slopes meet at the ridge. At the end, face a vertical triangle if formed. Hip roof. This roof is formed by four sloping surfaces in four directions. At the end, faces slope triangles are formed. Gambrel roof. This roof, like gable roof, slopes in two directions, but there is a break in each slope. At each end, vertical face is formed. Mansard roof. Mansard roof, like a hip roof, slopes in the face directions, but each slope has a break. Thus, sloping ends are obtained. Deck roof. A deck roof has slopes in all four directions, like a hip roof, but a deck or a plane surface is formed. Flat roof. Flat roof is the one which is either horizontal or practically horizontal with slope less than 10 degrees. Even a perfectly horizontal roof has to have some slope at top so that the rainwater can be drained off easily and rapidly. Flat roof may be of reinforced cement concrete, that is RCC, reinforced brickwork, precast concrete with flagstones supported on rolled steel joists. Efficient waterproofing and roof drainage is an important requirement of flat roof. In addition, a layer of insulating material, mudlime, concrete, mud fusca, etc., is laid over the roof surface to provide adequate thermal insulation to the space below. This layer is known as terracing or grading. Curved roofs. These are just the modification of pitched roof and are frequently employed in modern age to cover large areas. Shell roofs and domes are the varieties of curved roof. They are useful for big structures such as factories, monumental works, etc. Curved roofs may be constructed of timber or RCC. As we come to the end of this session, I would like to conclude by saying house is a basic need and it is a single time investment in life for everyone. So, some knowledge on house and its parts is very important. The components and the structural features of the building should be known to each and every individual to have a proper planning and the building of the house. I hope everyone enjoyed this session. Thank you.